It is the 1st of January, 1 o'clock in the morning. Happy New Year. On the 31st of December, at around 3 a.m., I woke up to go to the toilet and had my bloody show. It was like mucusy with a little bit of blood in it, and then I was just crampy ever since then. Then in the afternoon, I was blowing up balloons to do our baby mama dance video, and as I blew into a balloon, I felt a little leak downstairs, but I think my water's just broke. So I went to the toilet, but it was only a little bit of fluid. It wasn't, the big gush, which I was expecting. But anyway, I put a pad in. It happened again a little while later. It just felt like I peed myself a little bit, to be honest. I had spoken to the midwife. We then went to the hospital just to get checked. She looked at my pad and she was happy to say that my waters had broke. By tomorrow at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, if I haven't started labour, then they're going to induce me. But I feel like the contractions are starting and they're getting a little bit uncomfortable, and I'm not excited for how uncomfortable they're going to get. It's starting. We're starting the new year off with a really big bang. I am so nervous. I don't really know what to expect. I'm gonna go and try and get some sleep now, and we'll see what tomorrow brings. I was hoping this baby was gonna come out on the 4th, but I think it might be coming out on the 2nd.
Ta-da! We have made it to the hospital. It is around 2:30. Last night was probably one of the worst nights' sleep I've ever had. I was waking up like every 10 minutes with a contraction. I just felt like I basically didn't sleep the whole night. I did have a bath to try help with the contraction pains, and it did seem to work. It was nice, it was relaxing. Around 1 o'clock, me and Dustin led on the bed and I fell asleep for around 30, 40 minutes, which was so good. And I just felt like a bit better when I woke up. I was just so tired all day. I still look haggard. The contractions were rather painful, so I'm a little bit scared of what's to come. The whole time I was getting them, all I could think of was what pain relief they could give me. I was taking paracetamols at home, but they don't even touch the sides, to be honest. But now we are at the hospital and the midwife will come and do an assessment to see what kind of induction that they will give me. We'll see what happens from there. I was so tired today that I even started to vomit before I got in the bath. I just felt defeated. I was like, oh my God, how am I gonna do this?
So what's the update, love? Look at the heart rate of the baby. It was sleeping over there, you see, but then it's awake right there. It's sleeping. You can't see because it's all, and then it's just fucking awake, pricking. We're just playing board games and waiting and waiting. There
And
were.
what did you get?
I got a Costa Too Good To Go at the hospital, only for patients and visitors. And I was like, I think I count as a visitor. Are we doing that? Okay, three chicken fajita wraps, really? Three chicken fajita wraps and an egg mayo sandwich, which is for Jade. So I've got three chicken fajita wraps and they don't taste very good. We're waiting for the water birth. And I smashed Jade in, what's that game called? Well, yeah, obviously that's why we're here. But I'm talking about now. Struggle for Catan destroyed her.
Doesn't she it basically?
Ah, no.
And then, yeah.
No, I'm about to ask Dad to bring us some food because the hospital food, Jade got the menu and they were like, look, you can have a meat sandwich platter or a vegetable sandwich platter. And then Jade just looked at me like,
What did she say?
this is not how I want my birthing dinner, my last meal as a free woman. So we're gonna phone the dad.
No, but there was three options. She said the meat platter, the vegetarian, or you can always get your own food.
Yes, yeah, hint, hint, wink, wink, please. Our food is that terrible. And the way she sold it even, she was just like, so dinner is, it's just soup and it doesn't even matter what day it is. Happy New Year. I mean, and I try to dress respectably, you can see, so that, We're like, wow, he's a decent dad. That's how I want it.
Yeah.
Into the world with this baby. Jade's probably going to sleep the night. I'm going to go home to my bed. Oh, I can't wait. Have no one next to me just moaning the whole night. Just not letting me sleep, you know?
How do you know that, though? Because if they put it in me and it makes me go into labor, you're not going to just sleep.
No, I think we're going to get a considerate birth. This yeah. baby's going to be like, you guys sleep tonight. I'll pop out in the morning. Just we can hang out all day.
Yeah.
And then all of us can sleep at night. That's what's going to happen.
First,
yeah.
See what's going on with your cervix, and I'll then tell you what's going on. And if we need this or not.
She wants me to blog it, so.
No, I don't. We need to do this.
No, I'm just blogging this part for you, love.
Oh, right, okay.
You don't want this blogged. Oh, I thought you wanted the whole thing blogged. I just saw this as the perfect opportunity.
Right, yeah. That's gonna be
we good. Can just blur out anything, love.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, my love. We're doing an update now. Jade, what have you got there, love?
I got double cheeseburger, fries, barbecue sauce, and a whole lot of pickles.
Fucking cheese, love.
And a Coke.
And a Coke, yeah. So at what point are you going to tell them you're not even pregnant? You're just going
yeah.
Sorry, this is just a little Ronald McDonald baby.
We should do this more often.
Maybe your thing's not on, or the baby's just really...
What?
At 83, so this is now pointless. Sorry.
It's been on it for like 3 hours.
Good news, bad news. Good news we got McDonald's, bad news, baby's dead. Baby just is...
I think this is all that jowl dried up.
Yeah, well, it's just a very fit baby. Its resting heart rate is just incredible. There we go, love. There we go. Did you on camera and not embarrassing me? Show me your camera, baby. Okay. Okay. She's having contractions. So, not so nice. Lasting about a minute. Oh, we're in a bath. Probably what the fuck.
We decided to take a nice bath it's a candlelit bath. There was a whole bucket of them and three worked. And yeah, they're not really doing much. But then Dustin decided to go in the bath with me. Very brave move.
I must do what a good partner does. This is the inspiration they give you.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, my contractions can't be stronger than me because they are me. That's from Creed, Sylvester Stallone. And it makes you feel like fighting, hey? And then I am confident, yeah. Although I'm on Fident, which might be a type of drug.
Yeah.
And then baby and I are a perfect team. Are the perfect team with the way this baby's going. It's anything but a team player.
So you're not part of the team, love?
No, this is made for single mamas. Baby, daddy yeah. and I are the perfect team.
Yeah. Although you'd get MVP because you brought McDonald's.
Yeah.
So you've done the most out of everyone.
Exactly. Use the orange pull cord, it says. In case of emergency, pull the orange, but there's a red one. So you might be stuck for a while. You're busy falling. You're like, oh my God, where's the orange pull cord? If only there was the orange pull cord, yeah. I might be able to save myself. Say bye-bye.
Bye-bye. I've just gotten out of the bath. Oh, the pain, like down here, so uncomfortable. I'm hoping that I can get some more bloody cocodamol and go to sleep. It's just so intense. It's like someone's just... not like that. You know, not in there. Like, on there.
What are we doing now, love?
Lift going down. Please mind the doors.
Why are you standing here? Why don't you do that thing where you stand by the mirror and squeeze your pimples? Why don't you do that, love? Let's get it in all her pregnant glory.
Please mind the doors.
Look at that. You wouldn't survive 2 seconds in the wild. As you are. There we go. Look at that long corridor. It's like the start to the movie Forrest Gump, love. You can do this. Okay. No, she can't do this. Shit. It's painful.
What are you laughing at?
I'm not laughing, Larry. Why am I laughing?
You're laughing at me.
I'm not. Yeah, I'm not laughing at all. There we go.
Wow, there's so much pressure.
Shame, my love. I must be so sore now. Thank you for carrying this for both of us. If you could give me one of those electric things where I get the same contractions, would you? Don't even let me finish the sentence. Just straight away, but that would be pointless. I'd just be in the pain for the sake of pain to make you feel better about your pain. I wouldn't even help you at all.
No, just a little bit.
What a dick move.
It's not.
Hey? You didn't even let me finish the option.
The whole time, love.
Oh, just when you press a button.
Just like.
Oh, fuck yeah.
Just give you a taste of it.
Oh, yeah, I wouldn't mind doing that. Okay, so what are we doing now? Tell the camera. Give us an update.
Leaving the hospital because we don't think we're in labor yet. We thought we'd go out and do it ourselves. Please.
Yeah. Dr. Dusty, I got my spandex gloves.
Oh. Dustin, you don't put protection on. That's why we're in this position.
Yeah, well. Sorry, Dusty. That was very funny, love. That was hilarious.
Oh, there's our neighbors.
Yeah. They got pizza. Oh, sorry, I'm not doing a very good job of recording. Oh, there we are. She's fallen over again. Shame. Okay, let's get a closer.
Love, please.
Okay, I'm
love,
what? Yeah, yeah.
Please, I'm
sure.
In pain.
I know. While you're down there, love.
Love, please. Oh.
Shame, my baby. You can show this to our baby to make it feel bad. On its fourth birthday, she's just crying like, oh, no, I hate my birthday. Watch it, you selfish. Look what you did. It's like one of those Olympic moments where they trip and then they finish the 400 meter race, even though everyone's finished, love.
We'll just go for a quick walk this time.
Well, the way you're going is anything but quick.
Yeah.
An ironically quick walk, okay. We are walking. Are you ready for baby songs?
I'm ready
baby
for drugs.
Baby shock doo 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 doo. Baby shock doo 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 doo. What are you getting? Cocotamol.
Kokodamol, I think.
Kokodamol, yeah. Might be your last walk before your mother. How does it feel?
Painful.
Yeah?
Slow.
Painful, slow. Okay, but what about for you?
What?
Please mind the doors.
No, she's fine. She's fine. We're playing charades, that's
what?
All. Pregnant lioness. There we go. Evolution of man. I don't know. What is it? Okay. You've got this, love. Record you then. Oh, right.
Okay. Oh. 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 Oh.
Here we go. So you've just had some morphine in your bum. And the contractions are still sharp. But hopefully things calm down and you can get some sleep. Hey? Look there. That's her puke bucket because she wasn't feeling well. And those straps are there to make sure that the baby is fine. And so far all is good. Baby's heart rate is 139, 44, 41, 42. So baby's jamming. Mommy, not so much. Now we're hoping maybe she can get some sleep. It's been about 25, 26 hours of contractions now. Basically, as New Year's kicked in, I think she got her first one when we were outside looking at the fireworks. So she's been very tough. You want to say anything, my love? Hey? No.
I'm just going to wait till you finish. Yeah. That's been how many hours? Just happening.
I know, love.
Hello, mother. Can I have it?
Get high together, okay. And one for daddy. There we go. You're doing so well. I'm so proud of you. Hey. We should get a balloon and just load it with that, hey? There we go. There we go. Just keep on that. There we go. How you feeling? And my love? Has it kicked in yet?
No, they haven't put it in yet.
I thought they put the epidural in.
Yeah, but they haven't put the medicine in yet.
Oh, is that what that cord is there?
Okay. I was getting so high off the medicine there that I thought that they put the drip in. And then this would wear off quite.
See, that was not all bad, eh? You know, someone's had an epidural.
What?
Not very bad. I don't think this makes the final cut. But anyway, before...
Someone's our gardener. So we got an epidural after 30 hours of contractions.
Yeah.
I was about to jump out of the building. Punches. And I feel so much better. I no longer feel like I'm dying.
Yeah, shout out to anyone who's like, I don't know if I should get an epidural or not, just get it. It also makes it, by the way, makes it easier for your partner. Because now I can just enjoy the air and oxygen. You know what I mean? I don't need it. I'm now purely, this is a recreational habit.
Yeah.
Not a necessity.
Is it?
Woo!
We had morphine given to us. Well, to me. Because I was in so much pain, I was literally begging just for any pain relief at all. But they can't give you gas in there until you go into active labor. They can't do this, they can't do that. But anyway, the codeine wore off, and then I was just begging for something else. I was dying.
No, but first the woman came in. Tell when the woman came in to you and was like, hey, I've got, do you want me to get you some pain meds? She's like, okay, I've got, I'll tell you what I can do for you.
Oh, yeah.
Just to set the scene. At this point, Jade had been in contractions for what, like almost 30 hours, right? She's dying with pain. I'm just watching this going, there's nothing more I can do. Jade's just hunched over, just swearing, just not enjoying her life, swearing this is the last child she'll ever have. And then luckily, the midwife comes in and tells Jade what.
Okay, we can give you some pain relief. We can give you 2 paracetamols. And at that moment in time, there is no one that I've wanted to punch more. And I was just like, well, that's not going to do anything, is it? And she's like, don't underestimate what 2 paracetamols can do.
Yeah, maybe if you, like, break them out and snort them.
Yeah. So we took the 2 paracetamol and obviously did nothing. So then I was just begging for more pain relief. And eventually I was just in so much pain that they said they can give me a morphine injection, which will help me sleep.
Yeah.
So then I got that. Initially it was good and I started to feel sleepy. And then all of a sudden the contractions just started. And I just spent how many hours, just I couldn't sit down.
Sure.
The only thing I could do was stand up, because they were just coming constantly, over and over and over again. And then we tried a bath. It eased it a little bit.
And it made time go by a bit quicker for you, because it was an hour before you could get more pain relief.
Yeah, so it was like an activity. Oh, after we got out of the bath, I literally was just in so much pain, I just didn't know what to do myself. I was just begging for something really. She checked me and I was still only 2 centimeters dilated, so there wasn't a lot that they could do, and I was just at that point.
Tell them what you said when you found out you were 2 centimeters dilated, Jade. What did you say?
I don't know. What did I say?
Oh, fuck.
Yeah, for fuck's sake. And then we decided to get the epidural because I was just in so much pain and I hadn't slept. I was literally falling asleep, stood up.
Yeah.
So, and I'm not going to sound like her, so that's great.
Yeah.
And now I'm just still so tired, so I'm probably going to sleep again.
They should just bring people to a labor ward when they're trying to do those talks about, what's it, don't have sex as a teenager.
Yeah.
Just bring them here. Nothing is worth that screaming. Jeez, like.
Yeah.
Shame, poor lady. That's why you take an epidural, hey love?
Yeah.
Load it up.
It is 1:30 and I'm trying to take a nap, but I've got so much pressure downstairs in my bottom. It's just like coming every now and then. It feels like I need a really big pill. I did have a wee, but because I'm on an epidural, I can't go to the toilet. So I had to do it in the bed, in one of those little pan things. It felt like I had a massive wee, but then when the midwife took it out, it was only a tiny little bit. And I'm going to be examined at 2:00, so in 30 minutes. And we'll see how far along I am. I'm so tired. I'm so tired now.
How are you feeling? You fully dilated, love? How do you feel?
I need to push.
Okay, then push, my love. Okay, we're going to play some music now, okay? Hey? I think we get the vibes going. Shall we play some music?
Yeah.
Okay, let's get the party going. We're going to meet a baby soon. Yeah, buddy. Hey. You're almost a mama. Look at that. Suck on that thing. Give it one more hit. Whoa, man. Two puff pass.
It's been amazing, baby. I saw it.
What's it?
Yeah. Good news,
mate.
You're not having a ginger.
Hi, Dustin and Jade. Thinking of you guys, wishing you all the best. Waiting for the big news.
Can I tell it to your bottom? You can.
Loads of love.
Yeah, stop enough, Jade. You can do it.
Chat soon. Cheers and happy new year.
We're gonna get
cheers. Bye.
That was from my dad. Love you guys. You can do it now. Jade, that was the best one you've given us. If it's still there, give us another one. Use your gas if you need to.
Yes, ma'am.
They're on their way now.
Take your gas.
It's just me touching now. It's just me touching. Right, Jade, go on. Let's have this baby out now. Go on. Big, big push. And if it's still there, little monkey's turning their head. Is it still there, Jade? Yeah, go on. Really hold it.
Yeah.
Go on, Jay. Wow. Go on. Yeah, don't let me out. Because I'm getting my fanny stitched up to Wrecking Ball.
Out of all the things you thought you'd do with Miley Cyrus. Oh,
right, so we all...